Good morning. The catch word today, 26 January, is Republic Day, and of course, Padmavati, the film which was released yesterday successfully in many of the states of India. But of course, it was not released in four states. That's not important. The point is, what's the connection between Republic Day and Padmavati? Padmavati was a beautiful queen of the Rajput regime, and she was the queen of Mewar. The point is, she was so beautiful that she attracted enemies in the sense of Alauddin Khilji, who was so taken up by her beauty that he wanted to possess her. That's how the story goes. If you have read or seen the episode on the Discovery of India by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, you will see there that in the story, in his book, The Discovery of India, there is no mention of what happened to Padmavati later on. But it is true that she was a very courageous woman, and she went all the way to rescue her husband from the clutches of Alauddin Khilji. She, along with her brothers-in-law, Gora and Badal. But what is the relation between Padmavati, the film Padmavati, which was released in India yesterday, and Republic Day today? Republic Day, of course, reminds us of the joy of being a republic, and India, its secular values. In the light of all that has been happening in the past year against the film Padmavati and the director Bhansali, one must reflect and see whether or not having this Republic Day celebration should make us stop to think of what we are living, whether or not religion must become a reason for division, or it should become a reason to lead us more to a good and peaceful living in our country, which is a republic. Religion cannot divide. Religion must unite, because religion comes in is a human-made institution, but depending on our relationship with God. Dear friends, today, even as I make this video on Padmavati and Republic Day, it made me want to reflect on the values which come across in this film Padmavati, which many people are admiring the beauty and the hard work which has gone into making this film. And one also goes to one could also say that we are saddened by the losses which Bhansali had to undergo because of the narrow minds of some people, of some fundamentalists. I do not want to take names, but all of us know who are these fundamentalists who create problems in order to get their selfish motives across. It was said in one of the reports that these things began in order to extort money from the director Bhansali. And it was sad that sometime last year, even one of the BJP leaders said something on Facebook which was painful for any human person, any person, any artist who is doing such a good job. I really congratulate all those who have acted in Padmavati, and especially the director, for the hard work put into bringing such art and beauty across to people. I must say that the Bhansali has, what he has done is he has taken the poem of Jayasi and put across that story, which became a legend. Even though some of the things in the story are fictitious, Bhansali says that it is based on that story, and that's all. So those who say that the culture is being touched and the Rajputs have been insulted, I think they should look at it from the art point of view, and know that Bhansali, as a well-known director, would not want to hurt the sentiments of Rajputs or anybody else. We all love our country persons. We want to live in solidarity. We want to live in peace. We really enjoy being an Indian, a country which has so many cultures. And I am sure many more people will watch Padmavati, and I really hope those four states where the projection of Padmavati. Padmavati has been banned. They may come and they may decide to allow it to be shown, and with an open mind and with a critical mind, so that people may learn to be critical, analytical in their views and not just fundamentalist. Thank you, and wish you all a happy Republic Day, and Jai Hind.